We have built an organization here at the MIT Media Lab that is very deliberately set up to allow people to collaborate across disciplines.
One great advantage of the Media Lab is there are many disciplines, each with a different focus. So there's a sharing of ideas that is rare.
The good stuff is between these various disciplines, not within. Humans have always been social animals. Our ancestors used signals to communicate, to form into groups, to hunt, to protect themselves, to feed the young, to have fun. So when we look at actual groups and measure them, what we find is that the most important effect is, does everybody contribute more or less equally? That is almost 50% of the performance of the group. People often ask me, what is it that I'm supposed to do to be part of an effective team? What are sort of the bullet points to remember? The first one is communicate frequently. Keep everybody in the loop. The second one is you have to have everybody engaged, which means you have to talk your share and listen to everybody else. And you should acknowledge when somebody says something interesting. Also, communication is not just about the strategy and the topic. It's about building social ties, about understanding the context. So you need social communication to complement the business communication. And the final one is you need to understand the context of your work group, which means you need to talk to the rest of the people in the organization too. Over time, we've been so successful that we've seen the rest of MIT convert to this. One of the most interesting groups around here is the Changing Places group, and they're interested in how do you build architecture to support more innovation. We have to become more innovative to deal with big challenges like pollution and global warming. And what you find is by changing the way the neighborhood runs, you can make the neighborhood work a lot better.
We're working on urban modeling and simulation. We're using Lego bricks and projection with augmented reality. It's the intermingling of the knowledge and experience of designers with people that really understand the technology and what's possible. So one can look at changes in density, changes in the location of elements, new types of mobility systems. You start with data visualization. So for example, the movement patterns of people. So we can take that kind of information and think about how to provide alternative ways of getting around to private automobiles. There's an interesting correlation between conditions like heart disease and diabetes, obesity, and people's proximity to parks and bike lanes and more walkable communities. So we think we can begin to quantify the impact of design on wellness. A designer alone couldn't put together a tool like the CityScope, and a computer scientist or an engineer couldn't put together a tool like that because it's informed by both the needs for working through a complex design problem, and also it makes use of very complex technology.
In the future, what you're going to see is smaller, more agile groups that are coordinated using fairly rich data. How could we build better governments, better organizations, better families? By recognizing that the social fabric between us is at least as important as the individuality.